Hi, I'm Ben Felder with the Oklahoma Gazette, and we are here at the 2014 Dead Center Film Festival, an event here in downtown Oklahoma City that is building quite the reputation as one of the must-attend events of the year here in OKC. We've got a couple of films premiering tonight, a couple of parties. Let's go check it out. So two films tonight here at opening night, but the full slate of films gets started tomorrow on Friday, and one of those films, Devin Green, one of the writers here at the Gazette, you had a chance to write about actually in this week's issue of the Gazette. Tell us a little bit about that film that people have a chance to see later this week.
Okay. The film is called The Quiet Philanthropist, and it's a film about Edith Gaylord, who was a trailblazing woman journalist in the 1940s. She was actually a member of Eleanor Roosevelt's press corps. She was the president of it. And in fact, when Eleanor Roosevelt started putting out her own press releases, she nominated a female press corps and chose Edith Gaylord to lead it. So she was the daughter of E.K. Gaylord, Sr., and was just absolutely shattering the glass ceiling at a time when female journalists just, that was unheard of. And I think her legacy exists in Oklahoma. I think it's very telling that we've been a very trailblazing state for female journalists, especially in print, at a time when just print journalism for women was really relegated to the women's section. And here we had women leading the Metro section, being managing editor. I mean, she really set the tone for how women in journalism have done in Oklahoma. And, so I'm really excited to see the film. I've seen clips of it, but I'm really excited to see that. And then I got, as a chance, as part of writing about the article, I got to talk to several of my role models, Linda Cavanaugh, Sue Hale. It was awesome. Pam Olson, it was also amazing. So I got to talk to some of my, heroes, and then talk about, especially with Sue Hale, who knew Edith Gaylord. Got to really get a sense for like the person that she was, and it was just, it was phenomenal. It's been one of my favorite articles to ever write.
Yeah, what a really interesting story. We don't always get credit for being a trailblazing state here
in
Oklahoma.
Very true. Especially not where it comes to women.
Yeah, but important to kind of get a chance to see that some of our history does actually have some of that trailblazing roots. Some people are really into documentaries, some people aren't. If someone is not necessarily a documentary film watcher, give me a couple reasons why this is one worth checking out. I mean, kind of talk about why you liked it, but give me a couple reasons why to try to convince someone that this is a documentary we're seeing here at Film Festival.
I really think that Edith Gaylord, on top of the incredible women that helped settle this state, Edith Gaylord, like I said, set the tone for trailblazing journalists and also for women in Oklahoma. I really think she embodies a lot of the pioneer spirit that helped settle this place, which Sue Hale put it best with, this state was progressive before there was a word for it. And that had never occurred to me, the idea that this woman, this place was shattering boundaries before New York, before Washington. You know, there were people from Oklahoma were really breaking the mold. And so I was fascinated by it. That led me to investigate the Gaylord family and just things about it I didn't know. Yeah. And I think anyone interested in the history of the state, especially for women, I find that stuff fascinating. I think everyone would do to learn a little bit more about the history, especially of the Gaylord family. And she was also a close personal friend of Eleanor Roosevelt.
Yeah, pretty cool.
One of my other heroes. Yeah. So, I think it's definitely going to be compelling that people who are non-documentary fans would still find something of interest.
Yeah. Well, the film debuts here at the Film Fest tomorrow. Do you know what time?
5:30.
5:30. Mm-hmm. We'll put that information at the bottom of the screen right now. You can also log on to the Dead Center website to get more information and check out this week's issue of the Gazette.
Also, beforehand, there is a roundtable discussion of female journalists that did blaze a trail. Linda Cavanaugh, Sue Hale, Pam Olson, Jennifer Reynolds is going to be part of it, and they are having a roundtable at the Oklahoma History Center.
Is it before the film?
Yes.
Okay.
On Nazi City Drive at the Oklahoma History Center at 3:30, you can actually go listen to these women talk about what it was like to break boundary after boundary and be a female journalist all through, from the 50s all the way to modern day. So,
well, there you go.
That's going to be really compelling too.
Your evening is set there. One of the films to check out at Dead Center tomorrow. Thanks, Devin. Appreciate
You're welcome.
It.